Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're trying to subtract these polynomials right here. So again, you have to check what's in the bracket first. There's nothing you can do across here. There's nothing you can do inside the bracket here as well. So you have to go to the next step, which is exponents. There's no exponents, then you go to the next step. Now, the first one right here, there's nothing you can do with the outside anyway, because there's a 1 right here, typically. But nothing happens. So since there's nothing you can do about it, you're just going to copy down the very first bracket down. Now, that means you had to drop the brackets because there's nothing that we're going to do, right? The next part is that you have to be this is a tricky question. It's a minus sign, so you're subtracting another bracket. I'm going to just tell you the shortcut. The shortcut is if you have a subtraction of the bracket behind it, what you do is you reverse all the signs. Or flip your signs, or meaning that find the opposite signs of that expression here. So the 3x squared right here that you're looking at right now is positive. Guess what happened to it? It becomes negative. That's a negative x right there, becomes positive. That's a negative 8, becomes positive 8. Okay? So that's it. And that's the end of your question, actually. But if you can collect the like terms, that will be great. Negative 2, negative 3, because these guys are like terms, right? So what do you get? A negative 2 and negative 3. If you slide them, put them together, you get yourself a negative 5x squared. Okay? Oh, what am I? Cutter's going. Okay, there we go. Now, what is the next one you see? I see an x and an x. Okay? So that's a negative 6 and that's a plus 1. Negative 6 plus 1, put them together, you get yourself a negative 5x right here. The very last one is a 3 plus an 8. So 8 plus 3, you get yourself 11. Okay? Then this is your final answer for this question. Thanks for watching.